Hello, my name is Kyra Kellamilton, and I am a 2019 graduate of Gardena High School.
My name is Suzette Shaw.
Awesome. And what brings you here today?
So I am a Skid Row resident, and I write, talk, and advocate Skid Row from a woman's perspective. And I understand that these young ladies had some questions for me, so I'm happy to be here.
Walking down the street, homeless or not, is just, I feel like it shouldn't be, but it is very scary because there are people who are not, it's just not, they say things that are not appropriate, and there's just like they're predators, and it's scary because, you know, you just walking down the street as a black girl, and you just walking down the street, got somewhere to go, and you just headed, focused, and somebody can say something that's inappropriate, like, where you going? Why are you looking like that? Smile, come here, do this, do that. And it's very scary because, you know, if I was a male who was lighter skinned, I don't think anybody would be saying something, what are you doing? You know, they wouldn't be like, come over here.
So just so you understand that black women are the number one demographic who are disproportionately disadvantaged into poverty and homelessness, not just year after year, but decade after decade, literally. The numbers continue to go up drastically every single year. And black middle-aged elderly women are also the number one demographic. Now there are a lot of cultural ills that also interplay in how we end up being marginalized by society that continues to keep us marginalized and keep us oppressed. Some of those ills have to do with the fact of the lack of opportunities to quality education, the lack of opportunities to sustainable employment, the lack of opportunity to wages. The fact that, you know, we're continually lowest on the wage scale, and we're normally the last one to be hired and then the first one to be fired. Domestic violence is one of the cultural ills, intergenerational trauma. These are some of the HIV/AIDS epidemic, sex trafficking. These are some of the cultural ills that continue to plague us while also blaming and pathologizing who we are.
I want to go into you know, being homeless and what you perceived as, like, just walking down the street as a black girl.
Being perceived as a prostitute.
Yeah, it's like prostitute and, like, whether they're homeless or not, guys are so disgusted and nasty. They look at you. Like, I'm telling you, I walk when I have to get around because I don't have a car and stuff at my job. I'm just in Long Beach, and the looks, like, when I tell you, have you seen on my Snapchat? This one dude said, you too pretty to be walking around. Like, he was a construction worker, looked like 40 years old, and I was walking this early morning, I was walking to work, and he was like, you too pretty to be walking around here not smiling. And I was like,
oh,
and then I looked, and I said, hold up, and that's when I picked up the phone and, like, recorded it, because I'm like, at first I just was like, hmm, because people always say stupid stuff,
right,
and I just bypass it, but that one, it got to me, and I didn't think it would, but it was like, I have a right to look however I want to look, and if I feel mad, I'm mad, and you just made me mad, so I'm like, you know.
So let's
take it to another level.
Yes, like, I was fine, I was happy, I was in a good morning.
One level of being blamed for my situation, and also being told that, you know, I intimidate people, oh, you're so assertive, you're so aggressive. And these are some of the things that if I were a black woman, I mean, if I were a white woman or a woman of any other color, I don't feel that I would be pathologized the way that I am. These are some of the depth psychology of a quote unquote angry black woman, of who we then are, so that we're not even actually seen as human beings, you know? So you can blame us, and somebody your age and somebody my age, we're not even seen as human, so therefore that's how you can continue to pathologize us and make us part of a demographic that continues to stay oppressed